Precious Lord, take my got to fall. Take take my hand. Precious Lord, and lead me on. Mother is gone. My father is gone. They left me here. I got to carry on. But I get tired.
Hello, you mighty fine human beings. How are you?
We're doing just great.
What are we doing up in here?
We're having an Alabama good time.
And who are we?
We are. I am your sister, Christine Glassley.
Oh, there you go, Christine Glassley. I'm Barbara Patterson Bowen.
Well, all right then. Now, are we going to shake the house tonight? Or
yes,
what?
We're going to shake. Yes.
All right then. Can you guess who I am? All right. Leon Frazier, the brother of Bush Frazier. All right. How you feeling? All right, Dan.
Leon Frazier.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now?
Yeah.
All right. All right, you in Tuskegee?
Huh?
You in Tuskegee?
No, my sister was there a few years ago.
Oh,
Chicago.
Okay. All right.
We went out and had lunches over together. They want to come down every year.
All right.
Yep.
All right.
I graduated from Rose, Jones, Loretta.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, all right. Now, you was a couple years ahead of me.
Yeah.
You little Charlie no more because you ain't little. but how you doing, man? How's life treating you?
Good. Very good.
All right.
Yeah. My wife, she kind of sick. So.
Holler at me so I can hear you now.
Yes, sir. Better let you know.
I drove out in the store down there your parents used to have that we used to hang out at all the
time. Yeah, I sold it.
You sold it?
Yes, sir.
All right, what are they doing with it now?
They got some of those things, but I don't know where else.
All right.
It should have been done a long time ago. But it don't bother me, though.
So now, what are you doing over here today?
Over here? Something I'd like to love. Be back here again.
Well, all right then. Well, I sure am glad to see you because I love you not as much now as I did when we were boys.
Okay.
Welcome to the Alabama Reunion Group 50th Anniversary. Mistress of Order, yours truly. We will have greetings and welcome from the City of Livingston by our Councilwoman Iola Williams, Sumter County Commission, Chairman Marcus Campbell, Sumter County Chapter, our Madam President Gertrude Green, and then we'll have an invocation by Reverend Tyrone Thomas, and then we'll have a song, Lift Every Voice and Sing, and then I will return.
It's so nice to see all of you. You sitting around laughing and talking about the things that's been going on.
All right.
Haven't you all been doing that all last night and today? Just talking.
Oh yeah.
To your president, Sister Green, your other officers of this fine organization, And I have to call out Ms. Margaret Bishop Gully for just continually following me to make sure I'm to all the different chapters, ladies and gentlemen. Ms. Margaret, thank you so much, and others for asking me to come. It's just good to say thank you. Because people and no organization have to ask you to come to anything.
Absolutely.
And when people invite you, you need to say thank you.
Yes.
I don't want to upset anyone, but as I came over, Sister Green, my mind went to your husband, the late brother George Green. George would say to me, "Older, why don't you join the group?" And I said, "No, George." He'd say, "You just older." We would laugh and go on. No, y'all remember George. And I can remember Mr. William Patterson, Ms. Eloise Mitchell, Aunt Shane and Matthew, and some others. And I can call them out because they would always say, "I owe them getting ready to get in this week with the Alabama reunion." It is so good. And to God be the glory for this. But on behalf of Mayor Thomas Tark III, our council persons, Hiram Petrinas, the next one to him is Joe Moore, Reverend Carl Sutter, and our very own Sister Felicia Lucky, who's serving out the last 2 years of our Coach Nelson R. Hughes. All of us remember Coach Hughes. Isn't that right, Mom?
That's right, Council.
And yours truly, who represents District 5 in Livingston. And I try to serve as your mayor pro tem. This is a new position on me, but with God's help, we'll be able to make it.
Yes.
All right. We are so excited to have all of you here in Livingston, whether you came from near or far. We said thank you for coming. The city of Livingston has about 3,800 citizens. We have to count some of our UWA students because some of them have decided to make Livingston their home and they vote here in Livingston.
All right.
We are so proud of our little city. Oh yes, it's little, but we're proud.
That's
right. And I cannot tell you all what we got going on because we had to sign a statement to secrecy. But you all keep it. We are working on it. But while you are here in our city, we want you all to know that you're a temporary citizen of the city of Livingston and that you are amongst family and friends. My daughter often tells me, "Mama, a true friend is like a four-leaf clover."
All right.
Hard to find and lucky to have.
Oh, yeah.
We consider all of you all part of our family and our friends. And I'd like to say, if you need us, just call me at 205-499-0380. Or you can call the Livingston Police Department at 205-652-9525. You know the police can find you. Always remember, just a telephone call away. We want you all to enjoy, have fun, dance, drink a little, but don't get drunk. You don't want that sun get you a drink. And eat up plenty of food. I often tell people I'd like to land. The Lord wants us to enjoy life.
Right.
Once again, you are welcome, 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 and please come to Livingston again.
First and foremost, I thank God for this opportunity to be here this evening, and I want to thank our county's EMA director, the one and only Mrs. Margaret Gully Bishop, for giving me a chance to come in and say hello. Let's give her a big hand. Come on, show your love. Mayor Pro Tem said, drink a little, have a lot of fun, spend a lot of money here in Sumter County, you all. Do what you need to do. If you want to drink a lot, please buy up all what you need to buy up and take it to your respective places and have a good time. So leave all of your bucks here in Sumter County, you all. On this beautiful, beautiful weekend, we ask you all to have fun. Have a great time here in Sumter County. On behalf of our Vice Chair, Drusilla Ross Jackson, Commissioner Patty Zell, Commissioner Tommy Armistead, Commissioner Ricky Walker, Commissioner Archie Lee Hall Jr., and Chairman yours truly, Marcus Campbell, I say have a great time here at Sumter County. I've seen so many beautiful places, and I ask you all, beautiful people, please enjoy yourself here. This is your 50th reunion. So high five somebody and say, "Hey, I'm glad to be here in Sumter County." That's what I'm talking about. And again, from the Sumter County Commission. Mayor Pro Tem Williams said, make sure you don't get in no trouble. I'm just going to keep it simple. Dial 911. Have a great time.
On behalf of the Sumter County Chapter of County Government Reunion, I would like to welcome each and every one of you here. We're so glad to see so many people. We know our building is small, but we do not make apologies for what
That's
we
right.
have.
That's right.
So we would like to thank you and enjoy yourself. Be as comfortable as you can, and if there's anything we can do for you while you're here, please feel free to contact us and let us know. You've heard from these two people, and I feel the same as they do, and thank you again for coming.
Good job.
Lord, thanks, give thanks, and make your supplication known unto God.
All right.
As we look at the scripture for this invocation, Psalms 133, it is a dissension of David. When David about to enter into Jerusalem, he's happy because he meet an old acquaintance again. He's happy because it's not a sad occasion. So as we peruse this 133rd number of Psalms in these three stanzas, David says unto us, behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brothers to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, and went down through the skirts of his garment. As the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion, for there the Lord commands the blessings, even life forevermore. May the Lord bless his word. Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for all that you've done and all that you're going to do. We thank you for this gathering right now, Lord, that have brought us here from near and far. Some came by motor, some came by plane. We thank you for your grace right now. We thank you for your traveling grace that brought us and landed us here safely. We ask for your traveling grace as we leave this place and go back to our homes and other destinations, Lord. And we'll forever give your name thanks. We give your name praise. We ask that you would bless this night, Lord. We ask that you would bless every person collectively tonight, that they know that there's nothing that they're doing, but all things work for the good of those that love the Lord. It is in Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Detroit, Brenda Brown, Sumter County, Gertrude Green, and from Waukegan, Attorney Sherby D. Skirto, daughter of Ms. Lula C. Brown. Then we will have Praise Dance by Tasha May and Loretta Lee, and then I will return.
On behalf of the Atlanta chapter / Birmingham, I would like to say thus far we've had a wonderful time here in the great LA.
All right.
And everything has been wonderful thus far. But on our behalf, I would like to acknowledge our members. And we're running small, we're running low because of sickness and in death. But God is good all the time. And all the time he's good. But we're still strong, and we're going to move right along.
All right.
So we're looking forward to hosting you in Atlanta next year. With all faith to God be the glory, we're giving them back. So it's for the history of Atlanta, because we've been motivated by many people, and there are many people that has motivated us. So we just like to thank you, and we're grateful. But we have one member, which we call our third wheel, Miss Trudy Garden is back there. Trudy, would you please stand? And our business manager slash whatever the president tells me to do, that's what he do. And that's my better half, Clyde Parker. And I'm going to let him give you the history of our Atlanta chapter. Thank you.
Good evening, family and friends. Well, y'all look better than that, right? All right. So, we're welcoming you all to Atlanta right now. I know there's been a lot of talk about after the 50 what we're going to do. We're going to do it again. Last time y'all was in Atlanta, y'all know that the Braves Stadium was under construction. It is done, so all y'all Braves tickets can go as low as $18 if you want to see a professional ball game. And they got a beautiful entertainment place over there with food and eat, and you don't have to, if you don't like baseball, just go there, period. It's beautiful out there. And it's just like, right now our venue, we're still in negotiation with the same place we were before. That's a 3-block, that's in like walking distance to the Braves Stadium over there, and with everything else that's going on. So the history of our chapter is, we dreamed about this in 2001. I know I'm taking part of Boston's, what they have to say, but I'm going to say it anyway, because they have been a great inspiration for our chapter. When Francis and I met our cousin, we would go and visit our cousin Ed and Shirley, they would always take us to a party. And that party was always seemed to center around Alabama Day. So I kept asking them people, well, what in the world is this about? You know, and they said, well, you know, whatever the case may be. And then I talked to George, whatever the president was at the time. You know, and he said, well, you get with your cousin Ed, then they'll tell you. And then we got to another member, and she said, I'm going to send the history. Why don't you send the history? And I said, oh, wait a minute. This is all the people that moved from the South to the North and all other places for a better way of life. I said, now everybody moved to Atlanta. So we need a chapter. So we started this chapter. It was on the heart of our brother Ralph also too. And we started the chapter and we were graciously voted in 2001, 2003. We were sanctioned in 2004. We had our first reunion. We had our 700 sit down member, over 1,100 members to come to Atlanta for that reunion. We held it in 2010 and in 2015. Yet the numbers are dwindling, but we're still having a good time. And if, I don't care if it's 300, 400, or 200, we're going to have a good time tonight. Then. So y'all come on down and visit with us, okay? Bring the family, because there's plenty to do in Atlanta, okay? And we're looking forward for y'all. Thank you.
We give an honor to God. In everything we do, we should give praise. My name is Shirley Johnson from the Boston chapter, but I am originally from Birmingham, Alabama. Born, raised, graduated, and moved to Boston. First, I want to say to the Alabama chapter, you guys did a great job. A great job. I did not know Mr. White personally, and I don't know what was in his heart 50 years ago when he started this, but I am so grateful that he did, because we are able to stay in touch with each other. Even if we don't see you, we know we're going to see you at least once a year when we go to these various states. And thirdly, I want to start giving you some history about our chapter. We didn't come on until 1983, 14 years later. And we did not get chartered until 1986. But what we wanted to do was give back to the community. So our thing was scholarships and helping out in the community. So we got started in 1983, We gave our first scholarship in 85 before we were even chartered. So what we did was, we said, we're going to give at least two students a scholarship. We started off, every year we gave two scholarships, $250. And when we had our annual day, we gave two scholarships, $500. And I went to look when she said, give me some history. And I went to a book to pull out some information. And the page went right to June 10th, 1994. And this is what we were doing. We were doing senior citizen homeless food pantries. We were giving Christmas toy drive for Boston Globe that went on about 15 years until it was resolved. We were helping with diabetes fundraising through scholarships. And we were helping one of our members, George Green. He used to take city kids who couldn't afford to go to camp. And he would take 25 kids every year, and we would sponsor them. Well, if it sounds like I'm bragging, I am. I am so proud of what we did. And we have been given scholarships from 1985 up until 2018. And I want you to know, if you came to Boston in 2017 when we hosted, we gave five kids $1,000 a piece. And so far, we have given $87,200 back to our community. The Boston chapter, our motto is, we determine where we are going by remembering where we came from. Our colors are royal blue and white, and our members that I would like to introduce to you is Althea Harvey, our secretary. Our assistant treasurer, Bessie Little Moore. Our vice president is Edward Johnson. And we have a couple more members who are on their way. They are late, but Leroy Johnson, which is one of our founders. And what I want to tell you, and she called me about 2 hours ago, our president, Nicole Purvis Donnell. She is so sad that she couldn't be here. But her mom has been diagnosed with 4-stage cancer, and she is just on a time frame. And she just could not see herself leaving her mom. But she said, you all pray for her, and she is so proud of what we have done. And hopefully, if everything goes well, we'll see each other next year.
I want to thank God that we all of us are here once again. Some are not here. Yes. Thank you all. I hope that someone took notice that I walked up here on my own. This is why I'm so thankful, not just that, even though I am. I went from laying in the bed to a wheelchair to a walker, and I still have my cane over in the hotel, just in case. But it's good, it's just good to be here. I am sad, I know this is just a personal thing. I am sad, and I'll tell you why, not right this second. I just want to pay homage to the Cleveland chapter. We have been together since 1983. We call ourselves Chapter 2. Because we started after Mr. White. Really, Detroit started, and then we started in 73. history. So we've had a number of presidents, and we've gotten it together, we've talked, we've argued, we've debated, we've done a lot of things. We haven't given out so many scholarships, but we have given to those in need, and that's, I think, what counts as well.
Yes.
As a collective chapter, sometimes you want to do things and your mind is bigger than your wallet, your purse, your treasury. But we've done things, we've done a lot of things. We've given food, we've given help to a lot of people. And as we get older, since we started in 73, you know how long ago that's been, it's important to remember that things are not the same now. But when the organization hosts, I think we have given you all a good time in Cleveland.
Yes.
And I'm okay. Our mission somehow changed as we got older. Because the things that we did way back then were easier. Now they're not so easy. We're older, we're sicker, some of us have passed on. And I know this is not what you subscribe to here, but I can tell you what's on this paper, but you could also read it. Those things that we did are, they may seem minor, they may seem little, but at the time, they were help to those who needed it. And I thank God for all of us. Thank God that we are all here once again. I have a sadness. I can't introduce our officers. Maybe I didn't give you enough information about the Cleveland chapter. But our motto is, keep in pace, though it's rugged. And hopefully you'll let that kind of sink in as we get older. We've had a number of presidents. Some of our past, let's see, I know at least one of our past presidents here. Annie Evans. And myself. I think those are the past presidents that are here. But we've had a number of them. And our present president is, Jesse Hudson. Jesse Hudson. Yes, Vice President is Sheila Fields. Secretary is Lily Hopper. Our treasurer is also Annie Evans. I'm the assistant chief treasurer. And Bernice Jordan, who is not here, is our business manager. And Nathaniel Robinson is our chaplain. I'm almost done. I know this is just personal. We've had death in the family. And I just want my family to stand to a back to back. And just say a prayer for us.
Oh, yes.
Say a prayer for us. We haven't even had the service yet, so. That's what I mean when I say, we're a little bit torn up, but I just like for them. They're at the back table over there. Just pray for them. chapter going. As far as we know, you know, we're still in this fight. And we're going to do the best we can to put on a good show when we do come to Cleveland. Because you know we love having you in Cleveland. So please keep thinking about us and come back and see us again. Thank you.
My name is Eleanor Harris. And I'm affiliated with the Detroit chapter. And today I'm standing in for the current president, Brendan Brown.
Use the mic.
Our chapter motto, together today for a stronger tomorrow, and love and unity is remembered. It was founded by Philip White, and the current officers are Brendan Brown, President, Charles Evans, Vice President, and Antoinette Bonner, Secretary, Cassie Parker, Treasurer, Glenda Brown, Sergeant-at-Arms, Reginald Ballard, Planning Committee, Ernest Jones, Planning Committee. I just found out about 5 minutes ago I was supposed to do this. So I really don't know. I'm standing here helping Charlie, but I would like for you all to pray for me. I just buried my brother today. Connie Hill, I'm sure most of y'all, a lot of you, I know him. So thank you.
Alabama Union Group, Suffolk County Chapter. Current President, Gretchen Green. Chapter motto, remember the bridge that carried you over. Chapter, created date, 1977. Founder, Ms. Marie and Ollie Coleman, Charlie and Ruby Evans, William Sr., Bessie Patterson, Eunice White, Carrie Evans, Irene Lee, Maryvale Miller, David Robinson, Lynette Taylor, Adam E. Cooks, Earl Larkin, Willis C. May, William Patterson, and Lois C. May.
Yes. Thank you. Now, this is Lonnie, who's our vice president. And you know, we've done quite a bit in our county since we've been in existence. Since I've been in the chapter, we've given scholarships. We've helped people that have been burned out. We've assisted sick people in the community. And I know I'm missing things, but you know, we've done quite a bit. And our current officers are yours truly, President. Lonnie Mitchell is our Vice President. And stand as I call your name, officers. Margaret Bishop Gully is our Secretary. Gloria Lard is our Assistant Secretary. Remain standing, please. Ardenia Lawrence is our Finance Secretary. Gloria Crocker is our Treasurer. And Patricia Taylor, Assistant Treasurer. Alex Campbell is our Sergeant-at-Arms and Chaplain. And Mary Coates is our Reach Out Committee. And for the rest of the members, please stand. Raise your hand wherever you are. Thank you. And we are 38 strong. And we thank you for coming out.
Hello,
Alabama
Union Group. Thank you guys so much for putting my mother's name on the program. Margaret and reaching out to me. It's still a little difficult for me to talk about my mom, and it's even getting worse now that I look in the mirror because I look just like her now.
Okay.
You know, everything's falling down, everything right there where it turns was. So I want to say this. I took the DNA test for ancestry. We are Jefferson descendants.
You need to speak into the mic.
My great-grandmother's father was Ned Jefferson, something I did not know. And I'm saying that to say this. My mother died of undiagnosed leukemia, which the doctor said it was inherited. It could have been inherited. And that's why I took the test. But I totally was not expecting that, because that makes me related to everybody. But I can get it now because I understand now the land divisions. I'm like, is everybody related to everybody? So now I do get it, and I do understand now why people are not coming forth about information. When I first started, everybody was like, well, I don't know. And then when I would come back and say, well, so-and-so and so-and-so, oh, yeah. You know, I get it. But I'm just throwing it out to you guys. Our chapter, although we did give scholarships and we helped the needy, I think we probably was voted for the party. The party chapter. I think we partied a lot, really. We came in 1978, and I did meet Mr. White once. My son was 6 years old at the time. Our motto was working together in unity, and our colors were red and black. My mother, Lula Brown, was the president for every year except one. And she would be so proud of you guys, and she could stand here and look at all this gold and black in honor of Mr. White and the 50th reunion, because this meant so much to her. And you know, she worked hard at it. And again, I'm speechless, really. And I was when Margaret called me. But I just want to say thank you guys from the bottom of my heart. And as long as I can, I'm going to continue to participate. And the reason I did not bring anybody for the 50th is because I actually had a trial that the judge rescheduled for me. So I couldn't plan anything. And it was the 50th. I knew we should have did something big, but I just couldn't. So thank you guys. Thank you.
I'm not afraid to die. can stand right here and tell you.
Say it. Say it.
Lord, thank you, sir. I would not be ungrateful.
Yes.
After all the Lord had done, He gave me a little more courage.
Yes.
For this Christian race to run, one thing I sure enough can't forget.
Yeah.
And oh, the Lord has never failed. Yeah. Every now and then I like to tell.
Down, and I know He's
will have the blessing of the fruit by Reverend Thomas.
Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, we thank you for this day and many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. Now, Lord, as we're about to dine together, we ask that you will bless this food for the nourishment of our mind, body, and soul, that it may give us strength to preach in days to come. It is in Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
All right, what are you guys doing here today?
I'm a member of this club here.
Boston chapter.
All right. Are you guys putting the icing on the cake?
Yes, sir. As always.
All right, now.
We'll see you later.
All right. The man who knows everything about Livingston, right? How you been doing, man?
I've been doing good.
You holding Livingston down?
Well, I'm turning it loose. I'm at home looking out the window every day and bothering nobody.
You retired now?
Come on, Dave, up and pull a number.
Leon E. Frazier here. Born and raised in Sumter County, Alabama, Livingston. Graduated in 1955 from Sumter County Training School. Attended several of the Alabama Day celebrations. But I just want to let Sumter County, Alabama know that I'm really proud of the energy and the organization and the friendship, love, trust, and respect that was inherent in the May 25th celebration in Sumter County, Livingston, Alabama. I've attended a few of these over the years, but man, what a difference 50 years make. I love you guys, though most of us can't even recognize each other anymore. But then the camaraderie and the love and the respect that I witnessed in Livingston over the weekend was really, really impressive. Okay, so whoever organized this, whenever they did, way back in the year, I am proud of that. And I am extremely proud of the people who have carried on the spirit that was obviously intended for the Alabama Day celebrations. All right. This video was done because I felt really an obligation to get out and get it done. And I am proud that I was able to do it. Anybody wanting a copy of the 2019 May 25th celebration, all you have to do is contact me. Email L. Frazier, F-R-A-Z-I-E-R, 999@gmail.com. And if you want to call me, 334-209-9419. And I will get you a copy of it so that we can all be proud of our assembly on last Saturday. Beautiful experience. I only saw about five people that I could recognize, and sometime in that span of time we were able to identify each other. Some people led us to each other, and that was really something, you know, to be away from someone for 50 years and then come back together in our hometown to say, hello, how are you? And I love you too. All right. Okay, take care. And I'm glad I got a chance to get with about 400 of you over the weekend. And I tell you, you are loved, trusted, and respected as hometown people. Leon E. Chief Frazier, out of here.